8:38, Nashville's Morning News on Supertalk, 99.7 WTN. Time for the Gang of Four Amigos. Chris Hand is here. Good morning, Chris.
Hey, what's up?
Johnny B is here. Hello, Johnny.
Hello, gentlemen.
Ken Weaver, hello, Ken.
Good morning, boys. Yeah.
Those of you watching on Supertalk TV, I am feverishly hitting F5 on the computer.
Why is that, Brother Dan?
Because Chris Hand has sent me some audio that I want to play.
All right. Yes, sir.
And he emailed it, but he emailed it to the
email that I usually email things to.
He emailed it to the...
Let's be fair. I had the audacity to email it where I email everything else.
Every day.
Somebody assigned me out of my Gmails on this computer, and I don't understand why.
Oh.
Because it's my own login on the computer.
Yeah.
And so I'm signed in on all my Gmails on my login on this computer. And somebody came in and just signed me out of my show email.
Well,
which
who would
is,
have done that? Because there's not many to choose from here.
You know what? I blame Murphy. Do you know what Murphy did to me yesterday? Did Matt talk about this yesterday, the joke that he played on me?
Murphy Show.
Noon to 3.
No, what did he do?
I am leaving. I've got literally my keys in my hand. And I'm walking to my car. I'm like maybe 10 feet from my car. Murphy shows up and he asked if I was going to try to cut out before the meeting. Now, the thing with Matt, you never know if he's kidding or not. That's I love true. Matt Murphy. And so, because he could say, take out the trash, but he's got a smirk on his face. And so I don't know if he's, you know, telling me that there's a bunch of rodents in the trash.
He's an elaborate prankster.
He is. And so I didn't, honest to God, nobody sent me a memo about a meeting. And so I'm like, wait, what? Is there a meeting? And he's like, yeah, there's a meeting. And I'm like, it's just the way that he says stuff. So I said, okay. So I didn't get a note that there's any meeting. Well, I don't know, Dan. Maybe since you're no longer the boss, nobody cares about you, right? I mean, this kind of stuff.
Oh, man.
So we are walking, but this was so funny. So I start following Matt inside, still not sure if there's an actual all-staff meeting. And just so you folks know, I'm notorious for missing meetings. So we're walking in. Kenny Smoove from 92Q is walking out. And Matt says, Kenny, there's a meeting, right? And Kenny's like, a meeting? No, there's no meeting. And then Matt says, are you sure? And then Kenny, oh, yeah, the meeting. So now I think, okay, this is getting pretty elaborate because now Kenny's in on it. So then I'm just like walking. I say, is there a meeting? I go to the new PD. Is there a meeting today? He didn't remember that there's a meeting. So all this time I'm thinking that there's no meeting, and I'm just following Matt around, and eventually he's going to admit that he's kidding. It wasn't until I got in a room where there was a bunch of other people that I realized that Matt was actually telling the truth.
Well, then everybody seemed to forget the meeting, which was funny, because you guys burst in on me in the new green room.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm in there doing best. All of a sudden, the door just flies open. Here's Murphy at full speed. Oh, sorry, man. I said, well, do you guys need to meet? Well, we do have a meeting. And I think you guys are going to be meeting in there. So I said, well, I'll go work on this somewhere else. He goes, oh, no. The meeting's downstairs. And yeah. Then it hits me. Oh, yeah. There's a big staff meeting. I almost forgot.
The general manager actually thanked me for showing up. And I'm trying, this is, you know,
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
No, I was looking forward to this one. We were early, which we were. All three of us were early. Listen, getting down there.
I was 3 o'clock in the morning. I was here at 3 for this meeting. You're kidding me? I woke up at midnight. So, of course, with me, I obsess over, why would she thank me for showing up? That felt like a passive-aggressive whatever.
You thought about it all day, didn't you?
I sure did.
Last night. What did she mean by that?
I talked to Amy about it. I'm like, was this a passive-aggressive comment? And she said, no. And the fact that you've been thinking about this since, you know, approximately 10:30 in the morning this morning is beyond me. So, and then I, of course, bring it up on the radio.
And my wife even knew about the meeting. And which she remembered it. She texted me, did you have the meeting yet? I said, just got out.
That's funny.
Yeah, it was a good meeting. It was a real good meeting.
You weren't even at the meeting. You had, oh, I'm on the air.
Well, I was
excuse.
Working.
Excuse.
Yeah. That's Brother Chris Hand and I were hard at work telling people the truth.
It's part of the best, one of the best things about that shift is not having to go to the meetings. I'll be perfectly
you know
honest
what?
With you.
I said the same thing. So,
it's one of my favorite parts. I'm like, oh, perfect. Yeah, fit it right in between 9 and noon. That's great.
When I was on noon to 3, I was either prepping or on the air. It was great.
Yeah.
Then... Well, we all know what happened. Anyway, so moving right along. Hey, Chris, what do you got?
Do you remember when Ken was on vacation and the three of us were talking about putting Biden signs in his yard as
yes.
a prank?
Yes.
While he was gone? Did you know that we were talking about that?
I had no idea.
Yeah, we were going to do that.
We wanted to put a Biden yard sign in, at your house.
Well, listen, what we wanted to do, Ken, was give Fritz a place to crap.
Yeah.
Right on the sign.
So,
oh, damn.
So we really wanted to do that. We never got around to it. But these guys on YouTube have started pranking people while they're home.
Oh,
and
oh,
they're walking up and they're putting Harris Waltz signs in the yard.
Oh, no.
And then they're knocking on the door to let them know, hey, check out the new sign.
And this is what it sounded like.
Hi. Hello there. Hi. I work for the Harris and Waltz campaign.
Take it off.
No, I'm going to leave it there because...
No, you're not going to leave it there.
Oh, why?
Because I can't stand them.
Do you not support tampons in men's bathrooms?
No, I don't support tampons in men's bathrooms.
Why?
Because tampons are for women. Where are they going to stick it up their Get it the out of here. Well, get it out of my property.
It looks good there, though. Wait, don't hurt. Don't touch my sign. That's my sign.
I don't give a shit. They're a bunch of fucking communists.
You didn't address me by my pronouns.
What are you, he, she? F***ing transgender is what you are.
I'm two-spirit.
I'm two-spirit.
They better be careful, man.
Yeah.
It's been going viral.
I bet.
Oh, I saw that yesterday, man. She was mad.
Yeah, sounds like she got viral.
They need to be careful.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah, don't be coming down to McMinnville. It might be a different, greeting.
See, you know what? I don't see any of those signs anywhere.
No, I don't either.
Have you seen any? I see far more signs than I do Biden or Harris Waltz.
And the Trump signs are huge where I'm living. Oh, man. One is a monster.
I haven't seen... I saw some in Chattanooga. I saw some in Chattanooga a couple weekends ago. I know Murphy's neighbor put up a sign. Did you hear that?
No.
Yeah, oh, boy.
Murphy. Was that a Trump sign or a Harris sign?
A Harris sign. He said, it's a shame. I really liked him. That's the Cliff Notes version. Murphy said it much nicer than I did.
That's funny.
I'm not seeing any, man.
Me either.
I was every morning, I drive down Nonneville. And in Mount Juliet. And one, I don't know who this guy is or this household is, but it's dark when I'm driving in. They've got a flag that is sort of lit up somehow on the side of one of their outbuildings. And it's great. I see it like every morning. And it's so awesome. And then I think it's the same house that also has a Trump sign, Trump 2024. So there's all kinds of patriotism in Mount Juliet. So I would...
I'm not
Tell
even
those
seeing,
guys, don't come to Mount Juliet and try
I'm not
that
even
stuff.
Seeing bumper stickers. I'm really not.
My wife got me a garden flag for my birthday.
A garden flag?
A Trump garden flag. Very classy.
What is it? Okay.
What's a garden flag?
It's Thank
like a
you,
little,
Ken.
It's a little. It's a little mini flag on the little...
Yeah, it's got like a little, you know, like... What do you call wire? Not wires, but
yeah, it's like a little,
like little steel.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
Johnny gets it.
Yeah, I know exactly what he's talking about. I just can't describe it.
It's a garden flag.
Small.
Oh, that's what it is.
They're small, and they're all on a little piece of metal, and they stick in the ground. Basically.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, kind of like a croquet.
Yeah, a little croquet thing.
And
the flag is in it. It's just kind of a small flag.
Gotcha.
Classy. Okay.
They're very classy.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about now. Yes.
So you have a Trump flag, you said?
Yeah.
Growing amongst your marijuana that you grow out there in...
Man,
the devil's that, lettuce.
Where are you getting that? I mean, see, he used to do this to me. I'm glad it's deflecting toward you now.
It's fine.
Over there in the poppy field.
I know you are.
I'm just kidding.
The marijuana is in the back.
He's got his marijuana at my house.
What do you What do you grow in the garden?
Well, it's not like a vegetable garden. It's like a mulch bed. We got hydrangeas in the front.
Yeah.
And then
we're getting new hydrangeas.
You
okay, clip there's
it.
A new
clip it.
A new clip
it.
I freaking love it.
Ken and Johnny have seen my backyard where I had just, it looked like Vietnam back there.
Oh, jeez.
And so we actually hired some guys. I couldn't do it. So we had to pull all this crap out. We had to hire some guys to do it. And now we got nothing but a mulch bed, empty mulch bed. And the hydrangeas are going to be bought, you know, pretty soon. And what color do you have? What color hydrangeas?
they're white.
Oh, racist.
Yeah, exactly.
Any snapdragons?
what other? I didn't know you had such a green thumb, Dan.
Oh, I don't. That's why we had to clear everything out and then bring in the hydrangeas.
Any purple passions?
Oh.
Amy and I were trying to decide what color hydrangeas we wanted. And I was very passionate. I did want some purple ones.
Okay.
And she wants all white. I don't know why anybody wants just white hydrangeas. They have all kinds of different colors of hydrangeas.
The white ones are nice.
Well, so are the purple ones and the blue ones.
I don't mind the blue ones.
How about red? Red for Trump.
Do they have red hydrangeas?
I feel
like you just made that up.
Not me.
Let's go to Trace Atkins. Do you have any hydrangeas?
There's red hydrangeas.
Get some red hydrangeas and then put, you know, that's what you ought to do. Red, white, and blue. That's the hydrangeas I need.
There you go, Brother Dan.
Red, white, and blue, and I need to have little garden flags of the flag.
Yeah, like his little Trump flower bed.
That's exactly
there you go. That's what
we
need.
Need to do. By the way, I did tease this. I got to pay it off. What do you think is the most boring job in America? Ken?
I have no idea.
Johnny?
Working on our road that they constantly block.
Okay.
Until I flip them off, then it gets exciting.
I'm sure it does.
What did you? Do you have a whole list for this?
Just one. Actually.
Just one?
I have the most boring job.
So number two was making the list.
Yes, exactly. Number two is making the list.
I have no idea, Dan. I have no idea.
Accountant.
Wow.
Hmm. Yeah, well.
You know what else?
Just counting all day.
You know what else is the last 1 minute of this segment has also been the most boring moment of this show. Things that make you go,
isn't that interesting?
Fascinating.
What else you got?
You don't say.
You know what else I have? I've got, hey, Chris, what's coming up next?
Well,